What's crack-a-lackin'? It is Retro News Friday, and Chip and Dale is getting a brand new cartoon series. Also, we're going to talk about a new Looney Tunes cartoon that just came out. And another gaming company from the 80s just announced that they are making a mini console. We're going to talk about all these stories and more coming up.
All systems are functional.
Chip and Dale, which had a hugely popular cartoon from the late 80s and early 90s called Chip and Dale Rescue Rangers. They're going to be returning to TV on the upcoming streaming network Disney Plus. This new series is titled Chip and Dale, and it is currently in production. And from the initial look of it, this is not anything like the Rescue Rangers series that we all remember. Disney shared an image for the new show that you can see right here. And according to Deadline.com, Chip and Dale, which stars the world's most famous chipmunk duo, combines a traditional style of animation with contemporary comedic narratives. I've also learned that Disney has committed to at least 39 episodes that are going to be 7 minutes long each. And each of these episodes is going to feature the lovable chipmunk troublemakers in a non-verbal classic style comedy following the ups and downs of these two little creatures living in the big city. This is going to be a return to the classic cartoon style that Disney used when Chip and Dale had their own cartoon series back in the early 1950s. That show only had 3 cartoon episodes, so let's hope that this new series turns out better. But having seen the art style used for this new cartoon, I'm not really that impressed so far. It's going to take a really good story for this cartoon to make up for the way that it looks. The official air date for the cartoon series has not been announced yet, although Disney Plus will launch in the US on November 12th, so stay tuned. And next up, Warner Brothers Animation just revealed their first slate of completed cartoon shorts for their newest Looney Tunes cartoons. And we finally get to see this first short in action, and I am really happy with what they've done so far. When they first announced that they were going to be bringing back Looney Tunes, I was a little bit worried because each cartoon in the series was going to be both written and drawn by the cartoonists themselves. I was more worried that each short was going to be like the crappy cow art style that they're using on many of the shows today and not the style and aesthetic that we were really hoping for, or at least that I was hoping for. But it turns out with this first short that's called Dynamite Dance, it's directed by David Gemmel, and I think that audiences are going to really be happy about this one. I'll link to this that Looney Tunes short down below so you guys can check it out, and you can tell me what you thought. And then next up in our Retro Flash news, it looks like Annie Potts is set to reprise her role as Janine Melnitz in the upcoming Ghostbusters 3 movie. It seems like almost every day that we're hearing news of one of the original cast members popping up and saying that they're going to be in this new movie, which I really like to hear. But as I've said before, we still need Rick Moranis, aka Louis Tully, to join the movie, and then we're all set. And then we have the first trailer for the Banana Splits movie, and it is probably not what you were expecting. This new take on the 1960s children's show is actually rated R, and it's a horror movie. But you can check it out on Sci-Fi's channel on YouTube, and I'll link to that down below. Also, Rick James, who famously sang the hit song Super Freak, he's getting a biopic movie, and this is one that I am definitely going to go see when it comes out. No news on it yet, but I'll let y'all know when I find out. And for the gamers out there, Konami just announced at E3 2019 that they're working on a TurboGrafx-16 Mini. I never played the TurboGrafx growing up, but I'm anxious to try this one out. There's no info on the pricing or the release date or even what games are going to be coming with it, but Konami said that this information is going to come out pretty soon. So when you get tired of playing your mini consoles from Nintendo and Sony and Sega and Capcom, you'll soon have the TurboGrafx-16 Mini to check out also. And then last up, you gotta check out this new Karate Kid children's book from Pop Classics. If you wanna start teaching your kids early so that they're gonna love 80s pop culture growing up, this is a really, really good way to start. I'll link to the book down below for you guys that are interested. And that's your retro news for the week. Be sure to check out our next video right over there, and I'll catch you guys on the flip side. And remember, if it ain't retro, it ain't worth watching.